We touched upon it a little bit in the previous clip, but now I'll go more in depth to show you how you can change the waveforms in each of the oscillators. As shown before, the waveform is indicated up here in the upper left-hand corner of the window. This lever here is labeled as the shape changer, and it very obviously changes the shape of the wave between the recognized versions of the waves as sine, triangle, saw, and square. The tension is pretty much a distortion modifier, but unlike most distortion modifiers, you can actually distort the other way too. Instead of usually being square waves, which most distortion modules do, it can also bring it down to flattening the sine wave. And the skew actually changes the orientation of the wave itself, being sort of like the pulse width modifier. And then the sine shaper, no matter what shape it's in, will put in more sine waves to give it a sine sort of ringy sound if you're trying to make something like a bell noise. And then the pre-filter changes the wave so that if you wanted to have a sort of a filtery sound on it first, you can do it by using the filter. It sort of changes it to make it more wavy instead of sharp. If it happens to be sharp, it'll take away those kinds of sharp feels to it. Up here, there are three modifiers that you can use. It'll change the shape of the wave as you click on it, and it's also very intuitive because it gives you the shape and what it's going to do with it before you want to do it. They all have their own individual sounds, and you can play with it yourself in the oscillators later when you open Sytrus for your own.